In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today we celebrate the feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica in Rome. And today we offer this Holy Mass for Joseph Sandowski. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to the people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who from living and chosen stones prepare an eternal dwelling for your majesty, increase in your church the spirit of grace you have bestowed, so that by the new growth your faithful people may build up the heavenly Jerusalem. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me back to the entrance of the temple, and I saw water flowing out from beneath the threshold of the temple toward the east, for the facade of the temple was toward the east. The water flowed down from the southern side of the temple, south of the altar. He led me outside by the north gate and around to the outer gate facing the east, where I saw water trickling from the southern side. He said to me, "This water flows into the eastern district, down upon the Arabah, and empties into the sea, the salt waters which it makes fresh. Wherever the river flows, every sort of living creature that can multiply shall live, and there shall be abundant fish. For wherever this water comes, the sea shall be made fresh. Along both banks of the river, fruit trees of every kind shall grow. Their leaves shall not fade, nor their fruit fail. Every month they shall bear fresh fruit, for they shall be watered by the flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit shall serve for food, and their leaves for medicine." The word of the Lord. The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth be shaken and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea. There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst. It shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building, according to the grace of God given to me. Like a wise master builder, I laid a foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it, for no one can lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person. For the temple of God, which you are, is holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I have chosen and consecrated this house as the Lord, that my name may be there forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves, he said, "Take this out of here and stop making my father's house a marketplace. His disciples recalled the words of the scriptures, "Zeal for your house will consume me." At this the Jews answered and said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days?" But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the scripture and the word Jesus had spoken, the gospel of the Lord. Two things in this feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica. First one, the church is the place for adore God, is place for prayer. It's not place for shows. We don't come to the church for a show and entertainment. We come here to adore the presence of God in the Eucharist. We come here to celebrate the sacred liturgy. This is the most important thing that we do here in the temple. It's not place for other things. It's place for the encounter with God, especially in our temples with Jesus in the Eucharist. For that reason, we need, when we enter the church, we need respect, silent before the presence of Jesus Christ in the tabernacle. That is the first things and important things. Many times the people think that the church is a place for shows and the liturgy is a shows. I don't come to that church because it's boring. And the other church is funny. That is not the purpose of the church. The sacred liturgy is sacred. And before the liturgy, respect, silent, adoration in the presence of God. The second thing, we are the temple of the Holy Spirit through our baptism. From that day, we receive the Holy Spirit in our soul. And for that reason, we need respect our own body because it's temple of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit help us to enter in a good relationship with Jesus and purify us if we let that He purify us. We are temple of the Holy Spirit. We are sacred. For that reason, the human life is sacred. From the moment of conception, we receive that dignity. At the day of baptism, we receive the Holy Spirit. Let us ask to the Lord that help us to respect His presence in the temples, to come to church and celebrate with respect, reverence, and love the sacred liturgy. And the second one, help us to respect our own body and respect the presence of Jesus Christ, the presence of the Holy Spirit in our soul. Let us pray in silence. With confidence and faith, we present our petitions to God.
For our leaders and teachers in the church who build upon the foundation of Jesus Christ in their proclamation of his gospel, that their work may be blessed. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in position of power and influence in the world, that they may take God as their refuge and their strength, and do his work for life, justice, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the members of the church watered by the flow from God's sanctuary in her sacraments, that we may produce works of mercy and grace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus may cleanse and purify the house of God that is within each of us, making us holy and righteous in his sight. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who need our prayers in this time of distress, sickness, or bereavement, that living waters of healing and hope may flow again in their lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have gone before us, marked with a sign of faith, that as they were part of God's temple on earth, they may rejoice in his house forever in heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the eternal rest of Joseph Sandowski. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our refuge and our strength, hear the prayers of your church, for you yourself are the source of all devotion, and grant, we pray, that what we ask in faith we may truly obtain, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, the offering made here, and grant that by it those who seek your favor may receive in this place the power of the sacraments and the answer to their prayers, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in your benevolence you are pleased to dwell in this house of prayer in order to perfect us as a temple of the Holy Spirit, supported by the perpetual help of your grace and resplendent with the glory of a light acceptable to you. Year by year, you sanctify the Church, the Bride of Christ, foreshadowed in visible buildings, so that, rejoicing as the mother of our countless children, she may be given her place in your heavenly glory. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray
that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei,
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you enter under my roof. I only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. O God, who chose the foreshadow for us, the heavenly Jerusalem, through the sign of your church on earth, grant, we pray, that by our partaking of this sacrament, we may be made the temple of your grace and may enter the dwelling place of your glory, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.